Everyone knows poorly packed parachutes are generally bad for your health, and that regular exercise is good. Common sense, right? But if you have multiple sclerosis, your workout routine just might be as important as avoiding hitting terra firma at terminal velocity. Now, why is that? Hi, I'm Dave Bexfield, and I run ActiveMSers.org, a motivational website I started when I was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis in 2006. Today, I'm going to explain how exercise could be neuroprotective, why it has the potential to preserve cognition, and how it can dampen MS's most despised symptom. This is MS and Exercise. MS is a disease where your body's own immune system attacks itself, and its target is the central nervous system, particularly the protective sheath that covers nerve fibers called myelin. Picture a mess of wires running through your spinal cord in your brain. Only that plastic coating that insulates those wires is being stripped away, seriously fudging up signals your brain is trying to send to the rest of your body. It's like having one bar of reception on your phone, and it keeps dropping calls. As MS progresses, disability increases, but instead of being able to upgrade your phone, it's the reverse. Over time, you're forced to downgrade to a flip phone, to a car phone from the 80s, to a rotary phone with a cord. It's been challenging for MS researchers to find novel ways to modify this disease. Diet studies have largely failed. Supplement studies have largely failed. But now there is emerging science that suggests that exercise, in particular intense cardio exercise, may be neuroprotective, can improve neuroplasticity, and may even induce a degree of remyelination, a way to restore that plastic wiring. Exciting stuff, but wait. Ever go into the kitchen to get that thing? You know, that thing. Cog fog and MS go hand in hand. Sort of like pouring gravy onto your cereal, it can be pretty darn disturbing. Over 50% of MSers report struggling with cognition. Brain atrophy due to MS is in part to blame. And what helps prevent this atrophy? Exercise. The act of working out literally can preserve your brain. It can also beat back the single worst symptom of this disease. Tired much? Up to 90% of people with MS report feeling fatigue. Like that Baby Shark song, it's insidious, and it can be ever-present. Worse, drugs don't help, naps don't help, a pair of high-caffeine ventis doesn't help, plus you have to pee more. But exercise? Study after study have shown it to be overwhelmingly effective at reducing fatigue once a regular fitness routine is established. Now, exercise doesn't replace important disease-modifying therapies in multiple sclerosis. They are essential for reducing relapses, slowing disability, and delaying progression. But after DMTs, there is no better tool to add to your MS toolbox than a regular exercise routine. I'm Dave Bexfield, and as I always remind members of active MSers, be active, stay fit, keep exploring.